好，接下来我们 focus 转到冬季的流行性重大疾病。在美国，现在 RSV 呼吸道融合病毒已经变成最严重的危机。全球五岁以下的孩童，每死亡五十个人当中，就有一个人是因为被 RSV 夺命。它是未满一岁婴幼儿的第二大死因。而在美国的邻国加拿大，也出现了大量这个病例。它跟流感再和新冠三冠齐发之下，那么澳大利亚呢，现在也提高警觉，在近期他们的新冠肺炎疫情升温，还有邮轮已经爆发了大规模的群聚感染。
两名警察接获报案，冲进民宅，马上从家长手上接过女婴进行急救。事件发生在美国密苏里州，一名一岁大的女婴因感染呼吸道融合病毒引发呼吸终止，好在警察及时赶到，实施心肺复苏术将女童救下。全美 RSV 病例持续攀升，让各个医院绷紧神经。
There are no available pediatric ICU beds. There are no available pediatric general care beds.
麻州最大的医院体系在上周四宣布灾难状态，因为儿童 RSV 病例直线上升，已经让病床全满，并且扩大影响到其他病人。
Wait times in our emergency departments overall for again both adult and pediatric patients are nearing historic highs.
同样的情况也出现在密西根和乔治亚州。医生表示，虽然 RSV 并非新病毒，每年都会出现，但今年的情况却是前所未见。
The volume has been anywhere from 20-60% higher than a typical October.
根据最新数据，全球五岁以下孩童每五十位死亡中就有一位是死于 RSV 病毒，是婴幼儿一岁前的第二大死因。
They'd have to crank her up just to like keep her breathing so she could sleep. That's terrifying.
丹佛一名五岁男童在参加完万圣节派对后就染上 RSV， 还传染给自己不到两岁的妹妹。他的病情立刻急转直下，严重到需要住院。
I mean, it was like less than 24 hours and she was in the hospital. So, yeah.
女童在近期虽然出院了，但仍然需要戴着氧气罩。医生呼吁家长在 RSV 流行季节应格外注意。
Think twice before going to big events or those close confined spaces where you may be at risk of catching an infection from someone else.
RSV 一般只会引起类似感冒的轻微症状，但对两岁以下婴幼儿、老人和免疫功能低下者来说，却可能引发重症。医生提醒，孩童感染 RSV 的征兆包括呼吸急促、呼吸时胸部凹陷、皮肤发蓝，以及嘴唇、舌头和牙龈出现变化。但除了 RSV， 流感病例也正在增长，其中好发于四岁以下以及65岁以上长者。医生呼吁民众勤洗手，做好防护。
Of course, influenza is rapidly rising to the south of us, and probably will be increasing here in Massachusetts and New England pretty soon.
而在加拿大，多种流行病毒也正蠢蠢欲动。多伦多一间咖啡厅现在要求员工全部都要戴上口罩。
We just decided it's time for us to bring back masks, just to protect our business, protect the health of the staff and customers.
新冠、流感和 RSV 齐发，让加拿大儿童病患大增。渥太华一间儿童医院表示，已经开设第二个加护病房，并延后许多手术预约。
There are more ill.And requiring admissions to our intensive care unit, and that's why we need to create this extra capacity.
目前政府只有鼓励民众在特定场所戴上口罩，并没有强制。有专家认为，这对控制疫情没有帮助。
If the public health department says wearing a mask is optional, please do it. A lot of people interpret that to mean, well, I guess I don't really have to.But if the public health department said no, this is mandatory, a lot of people would say, "Okay, I'll do it."
至于澳洲的邮轮盛世公主号，则是爆发新冠肺炎大规模群聚感染。目前已知3300名乘客中有800多人染疫，虽然大多为轻症或者无症状，但却让近期确诊数明显增加的澳洲当局不得不绷紧神经。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想扩大国际视野，掌握趋势，请订阅专门。报道国际新闻的 YouTube 频道 TVBS 国际 Plus， 记得要开启小铃铛哦。